The Emerging Researchers Network has been developing quite a lot of what we might call innovation. One thing someone told me about was that you have lunchtime sessions at the conference. Can you tell me something about that?
Last year in Bolzano we piloted, it's called Lunch with Local Academics, and it's an informal lunchtime session where early career researchers can come and sort of sit and talk to a group of local academics, some of them quite senior, a number of them, you know, PhD students who are studying in that particular region or country generally, because we link in with the local organising committee and the national association in which the countries are running. And they just chat about, you know, what are the research priorities in that country or in that area, and it was so well received that we're running it again this year, you know, on a much larger scale, and hoping to meet the demand, because there's always more demand than we can really cater to. This year we're going to be offering Get to Know ERA and Making the Most of Your Conference Experience. Again, based on feedback, because a lot of them, the emerging researchers, said this was our first international conference ever, and especially on the scale that we are, even for the Emerging Researchers Conference, we're massive, and linking up with the ESA conference as well. And so I've made sure that we've got representatives from the networks there at this lunchtime session. We've got representatives from the national associations, from ERA Executive Committee, and some of the co-conveners will be there themselves to talk about their experiences as emerging researchers and how the whole ERA experience fits in, so to speak.
I like the idea of the ERA experience. But when we were talking before this interview, you were telling me that you were doing some initiatives around capacity building. Can you explain what all that's about?
So traditionally, we've always offered two capacity building sessions, which have been more or less around developing the thesis and preparing for the doctoral viva, and that will continue to be an ongoing thing. And the other one has been through the support that we have from the editors of the EERJ, the European Educational Research Journal, that is ERA's flagship journal. They've offered a session about how to select a journal for your publication, issues around open access, very contemporary issues as well about the problem of fake journals that is quite widespread these days. But then in addition to that, what we had emerging researchers coming back to us and saying was, you know, these are great and we really like them and we are going to engage, but we're also having problems even starting off with writing. You know, it's writing that academic paper. How do you overcome problems with academic writing? So in a first this year, we're offering a workshop, a capacity building workshop around that, and it's being led by emerging researchers themselves, who've been through the process and successfully come round the other side with great experiences to share. And in addition to that, we've recognised that it's also not about the fact that we're getting emerging researchers preparing for the PhD. We've also got to think about the longer term outcomes and the next steps. So we've got a session around how to realise your potential as a researcher and making the most of your time either as a student or an early career researcher. And how do you actually prepare or strengthen your profile for, you know, future pathways of employment or research achievements?
There's a special scheme to give support for emerging researchers to come to the conference, because of course finding the money for conference fees, especially when it involves travel to other countries.
So what we have, we offer travel bursaries, and there are three types of travel bursaries that we offer, because we recognise also the importance of the participation of emerging researchers in the local host countries that we travel to every year. So we have an element of local bursaries that supports their participation in both the Emerging Researchers Conference and ESA. And then the other types of bursaries that we have, the two of them are focused on European low GDP countries, and that's really, there's a lot of high demand, and that's our priority for the bursaries. And then the third and final type are global low GDP countries, so emerging researchers that come from those countries but are based in Europe and have their research ongoing here.
Would you like to give a message to people who are watching this video, to emerging researchers who are thinking about coming to the conference?
Yes, I think that in choosing to come to the Emerging Researchers Conference, you're making an excellent choice because you'll be coming to a forum where you'll have the opportunity to engage in really high quality research in a safe space that ensures your voice is heard. And really, I mean, prepare yourself to be challenged, excited, and inspired in this conference.